Hello, and thank you for watching our tutorial on searching the City of Toronto Archives database. Learning how to search the database effectively will help you find interesting material about Toronto's history and culture. The Toronto Archives is filled with amazing archival records, and the purpose of this video is to help you learn how to find them. We are going to start off by searching for toronto.ca/archives, which will bring you to our homepage, where you can find a variety of information and resources. Today, we are going to focus specifically on searching the database. To start, I'm going to click the blue Search the Archives button here, which will open up another tab. Now, for those of you who have used our database in the past, you will notice that we have recently updated our default database to the mobile-friendly version. Today, however, I am going to show you how to use the desktop interface. So after we push the Search the Archives button, we are going to select the desktop interface button on the top right-hand corner of the screen. From here, we will begin our searching. If you are doing a very basic search, you can use the keyword search feature located at the top of the screen. This is a good place to start if you are interested in browsing our collections and just seeing what is available. You can plug keywords into this search. You can search keywords like intersections, streets, people, events. Really, anything you can think of, the possibilities are endless. For example, if we type in the keywords Young Eglinton and click the search button, we are going to come up with 608 results, which are shown here on the left-hand side of the screen. You can click on the title of a record to see more details about it here on the right side of the screen. You can also narrow your keyword search by only searching for scanned photographs by checking the Scanned Photographs Only box. The Archives has 1.7 million photos in our collection, over 100,000 of which are digitized. This means you can view a lot of photographs online from your home computer. So after I check this box and push the search button, I get 79 digitized photos that I can look through. By clicking on any of these photos, you can view the scanned photos on the right-hand side description. If you want to see the photograph bigger, you can click on the image. Then, to close this image, you can click the X in the right-hand corner. If you want to narrow your search even more than this, you can use the Advanced Search button located at the top, beside the search button. The advanced search allows you to narrow your searching by letting you be more specific about what you are looking for. It is useful if you are looking for something very specific, while the basic keyword searching is a better option if you are just starting out and want to browse the system. Now let's go over the different fields you can use for your search and talk about what they are each used for. The title or number field is used if you know the exact title of a record you are looking for. You can type the title in here and push the search button to find the record with this title. The keyword field is the same as the first basic search field we did at the beginning. You can use it by typing in words or phrases. The date field allows us to narrow our search by creation date or date ranges. When typing in date ranges, though, remember to separate the years by a dot 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 and not a dash. Archival material is arranged hierarchically from the general to the specific. The level of arrangement field lets you specify if you are searching for a full font, which is more general, or a file, which is more specific. The type of media narrows your search by letting you select a specific type of media, like photographs, textual records, drawings, etc. The Scanned Photograph Only box is also available to be used in the advanced search. Finally, the last field is the Forms Part of field, which is used if you want to search for something within a specific collection. You would type the title or collection number in this field before you push the search button. Okay, now let's do an example of a search. So say you want to search for some council minutes. You would type that into the keyword field. Maybe you want the records to be dated between 1901 and 1905, so you would type that into the date field. You also want to specifically see council minutes from Scarborough, so you would type in Scarborough into the forms part of field. If you press search, the database shows the records that have all these specifications. Once you have identified records you would like to see, the next step is requesting to view them. So I am now going to go over how to order archival material. Many of the records at the archives are not scanned, so if you would like to look at them, you will need to request the records and view them in person here at the archives. The first step is creating a list of records you want to see. The Save to List button at the bottom of the screen will add the record to your list. You can also just check these boxes beside the titles to add them to your list. You can see the number of items you have up here in your list. As you can see, right now I have 4 records. Once you have selected all the material you would like to view, you can view your list by selecting the View List button at the top of the screen. A pop-up will show the items on your list. Check the items you want to order and press the Go button at the top. Pressing the Go button will generate a PDF list with barcodes on it. This is your records request form. You can print this form off and give it to reference staff at the Toronto Archives, and your records will be retrieved from storage within 1 hour. Alternatively, you can also download this form from your home computer and email it to us ahead of time, indicating the date you would like to review these records, and we will have them ready for your visit. Our email address is archives@toronto.ca. Thank you for watching our video on searching the database. Please look forward to more instructional videos in the future. Thank you again for watching, and happy searching!